What's going on? I don't think I have any idea what's going on. Dixie just called me the scum of the earth for the 500th time, and gentle Joe Martin practically threatened to put a bloody horse's head in my bed, and Jake Martin just ran out of here with blood in his eye. So I must have done something, but I have no idea what it is.
You butted in. You had to come over here and tell Jake that you didn't want him to be the godparent to the child.
But we discussed that. I thought we agreed. I was trying to solve a problem that we had already discussed.
And as usual, you just jumped the gun before you know all the facts.
Which are?
Which are that Jake is not very happy about the fact that you're going to be the father to his child.
His child?
And as I'm trying to reassure him, you have the guts to come over here and try to cut him out of the child's life completely. I mean, no wonder he stormed out of here the way that he did.
Hey, Al.
You got lucky. Another game, double or nothing.
No, it's getting late. I gotta go. So we play five games, nine balls a game, $10 a ball. What would that be? Right. $450. You owe me $450. You got $450, don't you?
Yeah, I got $450.
Good.
But you're gonna let me win it back.
No, I don't think so. Oh, what? I'm just supposed to roll over? Oh, okay, sure. I'll play another game. No, you're gonna pay me the money you owe me, and I'm gonna be out of here, okay? Is that good for you, Tiny?
You got a big mouth, you know that? That's a mouth that's gonna get
you
in trouble.
Yeah, well, you know what? This mouth doesn't speak up for me enough. So tonight, $450. Thank you.
Hey. You play me double or nothing, or you don't get squat.
What, are you kidding me, man?
Yeah.
Huh? Okay, he's gonna welch on his bet in front of all his buddies here. They all saw me win. You know how they saw me win? Because it was five games, one more time for you, nine balls a game, $10 a ball. They can all tell I got more balls than you.
You don't want to do this.
No, you don't. Take a look at him. Come on. Hey. Look, he's just a sore winner, all right? What fun are you going to have killing him?
Yeah, I'll tell you when I do it.
I have the situation under control. Thanks, guys.
What's that, Jake?
I can't understand you. Something jammed in your throat. Hey, son, you've had your fun. Time to go home. Let's go.
You brought your father along to fight your fights? Hey, where's your mommy? I bet she could get $500 out of me.
No. Oh, wait, I know, wait just a second.
I know where I saw this. This is an episode of those America's Wackiest Bar Fights, right? I knew I recognized you from somewhere.
That's a joke, right?
Yeah, real thigh slapper. While you're laughing over, why don't you take a walk and cool off, okay?
You're not going anywhere. You owe me money. $450.
Hey, your boy here is a wussy. He won't give me double or nothing.
Is that what this is all about? He won't give you double or nothing?
Yeah.
Well, look, I think you're within your rights. I do.
Yeah, that's what I'm telling you.
You know, I think we can come to an understanding. Really. What is your name?
Mortimer.
Terrific, Mort. What do you say you let me buy you a drink?
Did I say Mort? Did you hear me say Mort?
No.
My name is Mortimer. And I ain't ashamed of it.
No, and there's no reason you should be ashamed of it. It's a fine name. I had a great uncle named Mortimer. He was a brilliant man. He used to have great ideas. But, you know, the only thing about it, he never seemed able to catch a break. He never was able to show his worth.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Well, I would like to. Why don't we have a drink, Mortimer?
Hey, we ain't finished yet. Not by a long shot. You know, I can really hear what you're saying.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, I get depressed all the time.
Right.
I don't know why. It's like...
Tonight on a very special Jake and the Fat Man.
Stop it. I had the situation under control.
Oh, yeah, you had the situation under control. You want to commit suicide? Next time, do it in a way that'll benefit humanity, like live testing grenades.
Just want to pop somebody? Come on.
Yeah, you mean like pop somebody like... Adam Chandler.
You heard him tonight, man. He was like, he was already going after my kid. What am I supposed to do, huh?
If you want to pop Adam Chandler, by all means, be my guest. But come on, use your head. Don't go after a guy like Mortimer.
I mean, you're young, you're single. You need your teeth.
Dad?
Idiopathic solititis.
Emphasis on idiot.
Well, as soon as Mortimer learned I was a doctor, it was a few short steps to a diagnosis.
What is it?
I had to tell him that given his condition, if he didn't get immediate treatment, he was liable to lose the functioning of a very important organ.
Well, no more runs for the pussycat lounge for Morte.
I touched him. Should I wash my hands?
Does he?
Made it up. Call the emergency room and gave him a heads up. He'll give Mortimer a B12 shot and send him home a happy man.
He'll need a couple of stitches to his chin, too. Oh,
you know, that's another lesson for you fellas. Anytime you're rushing out of a bar, take note of incoming catch. Now then, either one of you chaps ready to give me a game? Move over, son. That's it.
But he was a donor. That's what I thought. Just a donor. I thought that's what he thought.
Well, he did. But he had some time to think about it. Now that the child is becoming a reality to him.
What does that mean? Does he want to be part of the child's life?
Look, all I know for sure is that Jake was there for me when I wanted to conceive a child. And it seems unfair to ignore his concerns.
Which are?
Which are you. Your presence in this child's life. You have to admit that you don't have the greatest track record with your own children.
Well, I'm yet to sell one into slavery. And I never once nibbled on him when I was hungry.
You didn't exactly shore up his fears by coming down on him this evening.
All I did was tell him the truth. It's the truth, whether he likes it or not.
I was just hoping this would all go away. You know, we would get married and you'd be Colby's father.
Yeah, but if that doesn't happen, remember who you're talking to here. Now, Jake comes to you with his concerns. He speaks rationally. He bats those big, beautiful brown eyes at you, and you see his side immediately. But I'm not that one. No, 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 that's not me. If you ignore me, I feel threatened, and I the first thing you know, I'm plotting to kidnap you and take you to a cabin. In the Tyrolean Alps. Mm.
Tyrolean Alps. Remote, yet luxurious. Oh. And surprise, surprise, a brand new neonatal unit on the premises.
Ooh.
Oh, I see you've given this some thought.
Only once.
Oh,
when I was stuck in traffic.
Adam.
My mind wandered.
Adam.
No, come on. You know, I'd never do a thing like that.
Oh, it's so Adam Chandler. No, you know you not. Would.
No, not me, not now. No, not now.
Yeah, you've changed.
Yes, I've changed.
How many nurses in this neonatal unit?
Well, there's Helga and Marta and Berta and Goethe and Sonia. Yeah.
Sonia.
And Franz.
Franz?
I'm an equal opportunity employer. Listen to me. When I say I've changed, this is exactly what I mean. I came to the realization that my future is with you. I need you by my side as an equal partner. A willing partner, and for that I can't force you, I can't fool you. I realize that my happiness from now on is entirely in your hands. So I stand before you defenseless and powerless. It's a new feeling for me. But not at all an unpleasant one.
It's a great shot,
my nice. George.
All right.
Well, I take it your testosterone levels have dropped into the non-lethal range?
Yes, they have, Dad. I was an idiot. The guy could have... Yeah, he might have killed me.
Right. On both counts.
As usual, you were there to bail me out. Just like you always have been.
just like I always will be. Now, if you mind moving your butt so I can get that shot.
Sure, okay.
Good morning.
Careful.
Great shot, George.
Great, this guy.
Bloody great.
Got any money?
I wish I had told you about Jake. It's just that I thought that the whole thing would just
come. Let's not talk about Jake right now.
Okay.
It's just a big problem, and I know we can handle it.
Together.
Yeah. No more secrets.
From right now, no more.
Equal and willing partners.
I want to make love to you.
Follow me?
You're delicious.
Oh, but Adam, it's not going to be like it was before.
Well, let's find out. Come on.
You sure you don't want to wait till after the baby's born?
Not unless you're worried about the baby.
No, no. Dr. Clater said that would be fine.
And you've been thinking about it, too.
Only when I'm stuck in traffic.
You're so beautiful. But more importantly, I want you to know that you're beautiful. And sexy. And desired.
Likely.
Why don't you give me a chance, and we'll see.
Now, don't laugh.
Only in sheer delight. Liza.
It was just something I had hanging in my closet. I bought it last week.
Cool player and a terrific diagnoser.
Saved me from multiple contusions tonight.
Not to mention lacerations.
Always there for me.
Believe me, when you have kids, you want them to feel just the same way.
I think I take it for granted, but I realize that I see the world through your eyes. I make decisions. Things make sense to me because of the things you taught me. I don't know. I guess my life wouldn't be the same if you weren't my father.
What'd you do, put something in his beer?
Shut up.
Well, let me tell you something. It goes both ways. I don't know where I'd be without you two guys.
I can't turn my back on Colby. I can't. I want to be a real father to her. And Liza's going to have to acknowledge that. And if she can't do it willingly, then I'm gonna have to make her do it.
That's my boy.
You're right. You were right.
I'm beautiful.
I've missed you.
I didn't think we could be happy like this ever again.
Well, we've got a second chance, my darling. We're very lucky.
Well, that's all because of you. I mean, you were the one who pursued me and you wouldn't take no for an answer. I mean, you did it, and I'm very grateful.
I came after you because I love you. I couldn't face the regrets I felt after losing you and our baby. She's really in there, isn't she?
Well, gee, I hope so. No, I appreciate your concern, but you don't need to be concerned about a consumer backlash. You're not at risk, and neither are we. I understand. Thank you. Thanks for calling.
How's it going?
I should just reprogram the voicemail so it says, if you're concerned about buying airtime from a rapist, push one. Ever since Ryan confessed, the sponsors has been on the phone all morning.
It's true. Ryan copped the plea.
Yeah, it's true. Trevor issued a statement. Ryan took the deal.
That doesn't mean anything. There's all kinds of reasons people take deals, Liza.
Oh, Ted, you know what? I believed he was innocent, too. I mean, he was kind of a pain in the neck, but he grew on me. I got a bad vibe about the whole Kit Fisher or whatever her real name was because of what she did to you in California.
Man, old habits die hard.
So, what do you think? You think he did it? Why'd he confess?
I don't know, honey, but if it's okay with you, I'm gonna go down to that jail and find out.
Take a tape recorder just in case?
No, I'm not going to take a tape recorder. This is personal, not professional.
So, you can have boundaries, but I can't.
Well, it depends on the boundary. I know about mine. Where's yours? Down in the middle of a baby?
Bad time?
I was just going to leave. I will call you from the jail, of course, if there is any news.
Listen, ever since Ryan confessed, things have been a little out of control.
So. That's all right. This won't take long.
Really, Jake, I don't have the time.
It's about the baby.
What are you attempting to make?
Oh, hi, Adam. Booties for you know who.
Stuart?
Watch out, I've got a lethal weapon here. Have you come up with any more ideas for your wedding?
Oh, no, I'm afraid I'm here on a more serious matter. Jake Martin. I'm hoping you use your considerable influence on Stuart.
Uh-oh.
Stuart is the only person who can convince Jake Martin to stay out of your granddaughter's life for all our sakes.
Stuart won't do that.
Of course he will. He and Jake go way back. He'll listen. Jake will listen to him.
He's made himself perfectly clear on the subject. He doesn't want to get involved, Adam. And I respect that, and you'll have to respect that as well.
We're talking about your daughter's happiness here. And your granddaughter's. Little Colby Marion? Did Liza tell you that I was the one that suggested Marion is her middle name? If Stuart can get Jake to back off, then we can avoid this whole ordeal before it ever begins.
Adam! Leave my wife alone!
Well, I don't know if it was a full moon or Mercury was in retrograde or something like that, but it certainly did get a little weird last night, didn't it? You know, I was going to call you to apologize for Adam's behavior last night, but expect a call from him sometime in the near future.
I don't want an apology from Adam.
No, Jake. He should have never come over and told you you couldn't be the godparent. It was very insensitive of him.
Liza, listen.
No, I want you to be the godparent. I want you and Ted to be godparents. I mean, it's a huge responsibility. And it's not just some honorary title. I want you guys to roll up your sleeves and get involved. Okay?
I plan to be involved.
Good. Well, it's all settled.
No, it's not all settled.
Okay. Well, I don't really have time to talk about this right now. I have a huge stack of messages, and I'm going to be on the phone all morning.
Liza, I don't want to be the godfather. I don't want to be Uncle Jake. I want to be her father. And I want the name on the birth certificate to read Colby Marion Martin.
Stuart, don't be upset with Adam. He's very worried about Liza.
He's trying to get you to get me to do something I don't want to do. How can you say that before you've even heard me out?
He's right, darling. We should hear him out. I mean, maybe he knows something we don't. Do you, Adam? Has Jake done something?
Well, not yet. But I want to nip it in the bud before he does.
Does what?
To lay claim on Liza's daughter. Our daughter. It seems Jake has this sudden surge of paternal instinct.
Well, it's only natural that he'd have some of those feelings, Adam.
No, it's much, much, much worse than that. He doesn't think I'm a fit father. He wants to stop me, to block me from becoming Colby's legal parent.
And you don't have any idea why he might feel that way?
Liza trusts me. I think if it's good enough for her, it's good enough for him.
Then have Liza talk to Jake. Because he'll listen to you, Stuart. He trusts you. Because I mind my own business. This is between Jake and Liza.
Not entirely, Stuart. I mean, I'm going to be this baby's grandmother, which makes you her grandfather. But you're going to be her uncle as well, so you see you're doubly related here.
If we're crying out loud, Stuart, it's not as if you're some disinterested third party. Marion's right. You're my brother. This is our family we're talking about. My marriage, my wife, my daughter.
Adam, will you listen to yourself? You're talking like it's all about you. Maybe you haven't learned as much as we thought you had.
Jake, we did a lot of talking about this before we did anything. And most of it was about how important it was for me to have a baby and whether or not it was right for me to ask you to be the donor.
I know. I remember. We spent most of our time trying to justify our decision. To Allie and...
Well, let's not go there.
Tad and my folks.
Look. We obviously thought we had it all figured out, and we didn't. We didn't discuss specifics, like the birth certificate.
I know. Well, I guess I just assumed that my name would be on the birth certificate.
No, you know what? I assumed it, too. I assumed it, and there was no reason why I shouldn't have assumed it. But I'm not going to be alone anymore. Adam's going to be in my life. And frankly, you know, what you're doing right now is not helping, and it's not fair.
Your plan's changed. Mine did, too. Not like I planned this.
This what?
This, all of this, Liza. I did not foresee feeling this way. And everybody told me I was going to feel this way, but I just didn't think it was going to happen to me. But it did. Maybe I'm being naive, but
I... You're just overreacting. I mean, you didn't know what your feelings were going to be when you saw the sonogram of the baby. So maybe you just need to slow down and take a couple of steps back and just try to process everything.
I've been processing. I've been... And I come to the same place every single time. I'm sorry, Liza, but I cannot let Adam raise this child.
Stuart, I've made some progress. This past year, you've seen me. I've been trying. You've seen me, haven't you?
He did come around about me, Stuart, and he did give us our wonderful wedding.
Well, then why don't you try just a little harder and let Jake and Liza handle this thing?
Because I'm worried about Liza, that's why. Did you see her face last night? When the whole Martin clan confronted her at the Valley Inn, she was very upset. That's not good for her, and that's not good for the baby.
He's right. Liza doesn't need the stress.
Liza can handle upset as well as anybody I know.
There wouldn't be any stress if Jake had just stuck to his end of the deal. His whole involvement in this was basically a business arrangement, nothing more. Jake was supposed to make his contribution and then keep his hands off. Having a baby isn't like a business deal, Adam. This one was. That was the understanding from the very beginning. Jake was to have nothing to do with this child. It was all going to be Liza's responsibility. All right, well then, if she's chosen me to be the child's father, then that's her privilege, her prerogative, not Jake's.
Adam, do you really believe that?
I'll tell you what I feel. I love Colby so much. I mean, I'm carrying her picture around in my wallet. I mean, a sonogram talking about. Every fiber of my being wants to be her father. I've been given a second chance to her. And I know that, that she can't take the place of the child Liza and I lost. But no, she can't. She's her own little self. Adam, I know you want to be a father to this baby and you feel that real down deep inside, but that doesn't mean that it's got to happen that way. Jake is having some of these same feelings. And he helped create her. Not you.
The hell he did.
What are you saying? That Jake didn't create this baby?
What I'm saying is that I helped create a place for this baby. A family. I didn't want her born into a broken home with two fathers. How confusing that would be for her. Poor child, and particularly if you were fighting.
Stuart, I thought I could count on you.
And I thought you knew that you couldn't manipulate me into doing a bad thing. There's nothing bad about asking Jake to back off. It would be better for everyone concerned if he would just let this thing go.
I think he's right, Stuart. Liza and Adam and the baby deserve to be happy with no complications.
Thank you, Marion. But Jake is a necessary complication. If it weren't for Jake, there wouldn't be a baby. I think it's good. I think a baby can't have too much love. I feel very proud of Jake for feeling that way.
Fine, he can have all the feeling he wants from a distance. But when if he's overwhelmed with his feeling, let him send her a teddy bear for Christmas.
You never were very good at sharing, Adam. You should work on that.
Any more pearls of wisdom?
Yes. The next time you want me to do something, I would like for you to come to me instead of sneaking behind my back and telling my wife. Because if you do that again, I'm going to be very, very mad.
I think I've had all the life's little lessons I can stand for one day. Excuse me.
Set with me?
Stuart, for the first time since we've been together, I just don't understand you at all.
Based on Adam's track record, sure, you're right.
But Jake, don't you trust me? I mean, don't you trust me? I would never let Adam be a harmful influence on her.
Adam is a handful, even for you. Forget about a little baby.
I'll protect her.
Not all the time. Come on, listen to what you're saying here.
Jake, Adam wants it to work this time. He's going to be on his best behavior.
I know. I completely understand that you want a family of your own. I know that, but I think you're being blind to a few things here. You want this fantasy, this happily ever after thing that with Adam, it's just a fantasy. It's never gonna be what you want it to be.
Oh, really? Well, maybe this is just your fantasy.
No.
Look, Jake, I am not some little princess who's running off trying to find my prince or my king. I am fully capable of taking care of myself and my child.
I know you are, but what if something happens to you? God forbid. Or your relationship. It happened before. You guys blew up.
Look, Jake, all we did was argue about money. Adam would never try to hurt me.
Why don't we talk to Dixie about that? She had a little stay at an institution because of Adam or Brooke.
Oh, no, you know what? I am not going to sit here and I'm not going to discuss his misdeeds or his prior marriages with you. I know him better than even Stuart, probably. I am marrying this man, Jake, and that's that.
That's fine. That's none of my business. But don't expect me to sacrifice my child for that cause.
Your child?
Yes.
She is my child.
She is your child. She's also my child biologically. I want to be the legal father. I've talked to Trevor. He says I have two options. One is simple. The other one is difficult. Which one do you want to hear first?
I'm sorry if I did something to upset you.
I'm not upset with you, Stuart. I just hate this whole damn situation. And I'm very worried about Liza. She's got herself in this terrible mess, and there's nothing I can do about it.
All the more reason to stay out of it. You're a wonderful mother, Marion. Liza knows she can depend on you if she needs you.
Thank you, Stuart. Do you know that you are the wisest and most honest man in pants? And in kilts, too, for that matter. I absolutely adore you.
I adore you, too.
Uh-oh. Do you realize this is the second day in a row we've had a tiff?
Oh, that wasn't really a tiff.
Oh, darling, please, can't it be a tiff?
You want it to be a tiff?
Oh, yes. Because, you know, once we have an argument, we have to kiss and make up. Don't we, my darling?
Oh, yeah. Oh, that was definitely a tiff.
Oh, good.
Oh. Mm.
Joe, excuse me. I was looking for Jake. Have you seen him?
Is this about Liza's baby?
Well, that was a very unfortunate turn of events last night. And I've just been thinking about Jake. He's such a young man. He's still staking his claim on the world. He doesn't really need to be burdened with worrying about a child.
Oh, wonderfully thoughtful of you, Adam, to be so concerned about Jake.
Joe, I've changed a lot this past year because of Liza. I'll be a good parent to that baby.
This is for Liza and Jake to decide. He's with her now to get this thing settled.
Settling how?
Well, if there's an easy way, let's hear it.
All right. You sign an affidavit that says I'm the legal father. Trevor will register it with the court and put my name on the birth certificate. That way, if something happens to you, nobody can dispute the paternity.
Do you realize what you're asking of me? If anything happened to me, I would want Adam to be the father of this child. I want him to be her father. This is not your decision. This is not your child. Please, we are friends. Please don't go down this road.
I know we're friends, and I value that very much. But my concern has got to be with the child.
And what if I say no?
Then it gets nasty. I'll have to file a paternity suit, Liza. We'll let the blood work do all the talking. Court will decide who the father is and what his rights are.
Well, I have to think about it, won't I?
Oh, okay.
Jake. If I signed an agreement that stipulated that you were the biological father, you know, in case of an emergency or whatever, would you be satisfied and leave us alone?
I can't do that. It's more than just the name on the birth certificate. Liza, I want to be a real father to her.